Hi, this is Jenny from Switzerland with another live review. And as you can see by the box on the table, today we're going to take a look at a new offering from We Knives, which is a company that is around for quite some years and did some OEM work for some US companies over in China and now started to do their own very unique and very high quality folding knives. So the first knife from them that I reviewed was actually the first one that they came out with, and it was called the Model 601. And it looks like this really, really gorgeous, unique design here by We Knives. Very nice flipper, full titanium frame lock. And if you're interested about this knife, please check out the full length review on my channel. I will also link it in my description box as well as in this video. We're going to take a look at the next offering from We Knives, so the second model that they are actually bringing to market. And they foreshadowed this a little bit on the box that the original 601 came with, because as you can see here, if you take a closer look on the box, you can see the model 601 right here. And then you see this little tanto blade right there, which is actually the model 602 that we are going to talk about in this video. So really cool that they did that, so you kind of knew what you would expect from the second model. So first off, when you get your We Knife 602, you certainly get the box that you saw before, and then inside that box you're going to find one of these really nice We Knife pouches, and they did that also for the original 601 here. But I noticed some differences in the additional things that they give you with your We Knife 602. So first, when you got your 601, you got two cards with it. So first they gave you this little business card where they just say the company name and it has this design. And then on the back side, they mention their website, their email address and their Instagram account. And here also you can see they foreshadowed the 602 as well on their business card right there. And then you got a secondary card, which served as your certificate of authenticity. And on the back side, you had your specifications, so all your stats on there. So you got these two cards with it. As you're getting your 602B, you're actually getting a redesigned card, which looks like this. So still you have the 601 at the top and the 602 on the bottom right here. And on the back side, it says it is the certificate of authenticity, and on the bottom you have all the information. So there is only one card coming with your We Knives from now on, which I think is a good thing to simplify it a little bit. Another thing that I noticed is that on your 602, which I'm going to show you now, if you open up your pouch, you are getting of course your knife, which I'm going to put away for the moment here to the side. And then you're also getting your proprietary hardware tool. So really nice keychain attachable proprietary hardware tool that you get with your We Knife, and that was also the case on the 601. But you are not getting a secondary set of anodized titanium hardware as you have gotten with your 601. And I actually wrote to the We Knives about that, and they told me that they had some warranty issues and issues with some different owners of the We Knives who tried to change them out, but they messed it up somehow, and they had a lot of customer support work to do here, so they decided on leaving that out. So that's a little bit of a change that they have made. I still really like that they provide you with the hardware tool here. Really nice if you have to adjust the pivot or anything like that. Now that we have talked about the packaging and everything that comes with the knife, let's take a look at the knife itself. And here it is, the We Knives Model 602B, a really gorgeous tanto design from We Knives. And this is the B model, so the differences between the B and the A model is the finishing. So the B model right here has gorgeous anodizing work done on the handle. So you have the edges here where it is machined are all anodized in a really nice green color. And then the middle part here where it is very high satin finished, it is a vibrant blue color, very nicely finished. And then you have the purple hardware to set it all off as well. On the A model itself, it has a black wash finish around the edges, and then the middle part is just a very high satin finished raw titanium color. And that is also why the A model is called the black and white one. Both of the models have a black washed tanto blade. I think there are certainly going to be a lot more varieties available of this blade with different finishes, as there were on the model 601. There are really a lot of different finishes here on the 601 available, and they are designated by the last letter, so you know which one you are getting. Now let's take a look at the specs of this knife, as we do always. So we have an overall length here on the V-Knife model 602 of 8.66 inches or 22 centimeters. That gives you a blade length of 3.62 inches or 9.2 centimeters. The steel on this knife is the CPM S35VN, and the blade thickness here is also 4 millimeters as on the 601. And you have a handle length of 5.04 inches or 12.8 centimeters. So a really nice full-sized knife that you get here from V-Knife. Very close in size to the original 601 and also really nice in hand. Love the tanto blade shape. And of course the materials are all top-notch. You have a really, really high-end steel with the CPM S35VN full titanium handle with a frame lock. So really, really nice high-end blade here from V-Knife's. Really cool design overall. Now let's take a look at the weight of the knife, and it weighs 149 grams or 5.25 ounces, which is actually quite a nice weight for a knife of this size and construction with the full titanium frame lock. Even though it is about half an ounce heavier than the original 601, and that is of course the case because they have used a broader blade and also a broader overall design, which leads to more material being used. But as on the 601, also on the 602 here, they did everything they could to minimize the weight of this blade. As you can see here on the inside, there is a lot of milling going on. They really milled down the scales from the inside, so to reduce the weight as much as possible. So really, really well done here on the weight reduction measures that they have taken to reduce the weight of the 602. Now let's take a closer look at the 3.62 inch long CPM S35VN blade of the V-Knife 602, and you can see you have a very, very unique and gorgeous tanto blade shape here on this knife, with a really interesting and good looking fuller running all the way across here at the top with three holes in it, which add another very interesting design element. You also have a flat grind running from the fuller all the way down, and really nice tanto grind lines as well. The finish on the blade is a black wash finish with a really nice and vibrant black color. They really did that very well. Just gorgeous. You have 4 millimeter of blade thickness, as I told you before. Really, really nice and functional jimping here at the top, but it is not so coarse that it hurts you, but it locks your finger in very, very well. You also can see that the spine of the blade is chamfered really, really nicely done here. I love the tanto blade shape here on the 602. You also get a very nice and robust blade tip on the 602. Just gorgeously executed. And they come razor, razor sharp out of the box from V-Knives. Also there, they do a fantastic job. And you also can see that there are no markings on the blade whatsoever. And they did a really, really cool trick for the steel marking. You know, on the 601, the steel marking was on the tang on the blade on the inside. And here you don't see any steel marking. But if I unlock the blade and close it down, you see that the fuller actually extends into the handle. And there it reveals the steel choice, which is S35VN, which is a powder metallurgy technology steel made by Crucible in the USA. It is a really nice improved version of the S30V steel and was actually developed by Crucible in collaboration with Chris Reeve from Chris Reeve Knife. And this is a really, really nice high quality premium stainless steel with excellent corrosion resistance, edge retention and toughness. Really nicely improved toughness over the S30V, so it's not going to chip out easily on you. And it also has a very nice refined grain structure because of the powder metallurgy process that they're doing there. And so it can be sharpened to a razor's edge. And they really did that here on this V-Knife. It comes really hair popping sharp out of the box. So really, really gorgeous blade design and execution here on the 602. Very well done, V-Knife. Loving the blade shape here on this knife as well as the steel choice. Now let's take a closer look at the handle design and construction of this knife, and you can see there is a lot going on here on that handle. I don't even know where to start, but let's start with the proprietary hardware, which is anodized purple. And here the highlights are anodized gold on the pivot screw, where it states the name of the company, WE. And of course, all the hardware is also titanium. That's why they can anodize it in a way that they have done it here. So really nice purple hardware. You have the pivot screw here at the pivot. And then you have two body screws here in the back as well, which are their proprietary star screws, which are easily disassembled by the tool that you get with your WE Knife 602. Here on the other side, you can see the male end of the pivot screw, and then you have your screw for the stainless steel insert as well. So really nice pop of color by the titanium hardware. And here you can also see the really, really futuristic design with all the cutouts and the anodizing. It really looks very, very good. You can also see that the blade almost hides completely inside the handle, which I really like. It reminds me a little bit of a Quaken design. And one other thing that I noticed was here how they did actually the cutout for the lock bar. So you can see that there is a stepped cutout. So you have thicker titanium here on the edges, where it maybe is going to be exposed to more wear or more tension. And then it is milled deeper down here on the inside of the handle. So really, really nicely done here. They really thought about that one. You also have some additional jimping here on the bottom part of the handle as well. And I really like this two-tone finish and also the different finishing here on the handle edges, where you have the machining that they have done here to give you a little bit more traction. They did a similar thing on the 601, and I really liked it there as well. And then you have the polished or high set and finished middle part, which is anodized in a really nice rich blue. I think the camera that I have here and the lighting doesn't do it justice. I will inlay some pictures where you can see how nice and vibrant the blue looks in direct sunlight. So it's really, really gorgeous. And you also can see there is no scratch here on that finish. It is just done very, very well. And one big star of this knife handle is the pocket clip. I think this is probably the best pocket clip I have ever seen on a folding knife, and a big improvement over the already excellent pocket clip of the 601. And you can see here it is also made out of titanium. It has these keyhole cutouts that mirror the cutouts here on the handle on the presentation side. And then the big thing I'm talking about is that it is a milled titanium clip, and it is also deep carry. I have never seen that done by any kind of other manufacturer. It carries very deep, and it is still a very high quality milled titanium clip. Just the perfect combination of these two things in my opinion, and it lands on the very nicely set and finished and smooth surface here on the middle, so it's easy to get in and out of the pocket but still has enough tension to not fall out. So very, very well executed here on the pocket clip. They also have their logo lasered onto the pocket clip right here. So overall, a fantastic pocket clip. Also, the backspacer is a total home run for me. You see it is also anodized green. On the black and white model, the pocket clip and the backspacer are actually anodized purple, which is a really nice pop of color on that model. And you can see here it's a very similar backspacer to the one on the 601. You also have the perfectly integrated lanyard loop, which is very easy to use and still does not take away from the overall design of the blade. You also have some jimping on the backspacer, which is really nice, fine and functional jimping as well. Also here on the back for a reverse grip. You also have your cutout here for your finger, which is also anodized green. Just everything looks so nicely finished. And it's very, very well done. Here you can peek into the pivot point as well. And there you can maybe take a look at the multi-row ceramic bearing system that they're using here. The same bearing they used on the 601, and gives these knives the unbelievable smoothness that they have. Here you can also take a look at the stop pin. Really nice, massive stop pin. So certainly not going to be an issue here. You also can see it is partly a flow-through construction, where the backspacer ends, and of course it is heavily skeletonized to keep the weight down as much as possible. Here you also can see the very, very functional milling that they have done on the lock bar. You can see you have chamfering on both sides and some little cutouts, so it's very easy to disengage the lock bar. You just can drop your thumb in and disengage it like that. And they also have done some slight texturing or jimping on the locking liner, so it's really easy to disengage that lock bar. And they of course have their stainless steel insert, which is executed the same way as on the 601, as you can see here on the inside. Nice stainless steel insert, and you don't see it from the outside except for the screw. It also acts as your over travel stop. Maybe we can see that from this side. Maybe not, because the cutout is also very slim. You can see there is not a lot of gap between the lock bar and the actual handle scale. And you can also see that the chamfer here is actually anodized green. Same thing here on the cutouts on the handle. On the keyhole cutouts, you can see that the inside chamfer is also anodized green. There are just so much little details here on this handle, it's hard to cover them all. But it is just a fantastically built folder here by Weknife, with a gorgeous overall design. And it's also very nice in hand here for my sized hands. You can see I still have quite a bit of space here on the back, but it fits very well. I love the jimping on the top, it really locks your thumb in. And in every grip you can imagine, it feels just very nice. You have here the jimping at the end to keep your thumb in the right place. Just very nicely executed. Now let's take a look at centering, lockup, and deployment of this blade. And the action on these Wii knives is just incredible. I really have not experienced a lot of knives that are that smooth. And you can see it's a really nice flipper, and the multi-row ceramic ball bearings make it extremely smooth right out of the box. I now had it for 2 weeks, and it still is getting smoother and smoother as you are flipping it and using it. Just a gorgeous action. It's just so smooth, as you can see here. It is of course a free faller, and then you just have to turn the blade and it's going to fall into the handle. So really gorgeous action. One thing that I noticed is that the detent is slightly less pronounced than on the Weknife 601, and I also noticed a difference in the flipper geometry. You can see here that the flipper on the 601 is much more forward, right on the edge of the handle right here, and the flipper on the 602 is a little bit further back but still has a nice angle to the pivot. So both are really nice flippers, and both of them are actually jimped, as you can see here. A little bit of a different jimping. You have finer, more aggressive jimping on the 601 at the top, and a little bit coarser jimping here on the 602. But both flippers work exceptionally well. They shoot out with authority and close with their extremely smooth ceramic multi-row ball bearing system that they use here. Really nicely executed. And of course, they have absolutely no side to side, no up and down play. Here you can take a look at the lockup of the titanium lock bar with the stainless steel insert. I would say this is about 30, maybe 40%. Really nice, right where I want to have it. And then of course centering on these knives is as well done just perfectly. As you can see here, dead center, really nicely done. Now let's take a look at the sharpness of this knife. And I had it now for 2 weeks, as I told you before, and had it in my EDC rotation since then. And it came razor sharp out of the box from Weknife. And let's see how sharp it is after 2 weeks of EDC use. And you can see it still is razor sharp. Has absolutely no problem slicing this paper here, just with ease. Really impressive work that they do here on their blades. It was the same way on my 601, so they really deliver high quality performance here on their S35 VN steel blades. They really know what they're doing here in sharpening these blades. Just absolutely perfect sharpness. Now let's come to the size comparisons I like to do, and the first size comparisons of course is going to be the Weknife 601, as you have seen it here before on this video. And here you can see that those two knives are very close in overall length. I think they're actually identical by the stats provided by Weknife. Both of them are 22 centimeters long overall. But you can see design-wise, we have a much broader handle and broader blade here on the 602. And of course, the anodizing is also a big difference on these two knives. Thickness-wise, I think they are pretty close. You can see here. And here you can see the thing I talked about on the Poco clip. Both are very excellent. Both are milled titanium clips. But here you have two screws in the back. And this titanium clip is just inset into the frame here on the back. I actually don't know how they attach this clip to the handle. But you can see both are excellent knives, very close in the overall size. The next comparison I have for you is also a Tanto blade, and also one of my favorites in my collection. It is made in the USA and is the Hogue EX01 with the 3.5-inch long Tanto blade out of 154 cm steel, aluminum handle, button lock, Alan Elishowitz design. Of course, this is going to be slightly smaller overall, and just both of them are very nice, high quality blades. Thickness wise, the Hogue is going to be a bit thicker overall than the Weknife 602, and the Poco clip is no discussion here. I always said that I don't like the spoon Poco clip here on the Hogue. And the last comparison I have for you is also a Tanto blade, and it is one of my favorite, if not my favorite, large tactical folder, and it is the Bad Monkey from Southern Grind. Really, really nice blade overall, and this is going to be slightly longer as well because it has a 4-inch blade. Thickness wise, you can see here the Weknife is going to be considerably thinner, and then Poco clip wise, I would certainly give it to the Weknife, even though I like these stubby clips here on these Southern Grind knives. Now let's talk about value and price and come to a final conclusion about this knife. So if you want to get yourself your own Weknife 602 A or B, you're going to pay $290, and you can get it from a bunch of online sellers like Blade HQ, Knife Center, Blades 101, and so on. So now they are really much more available than they were when I first reviewed the 601. And I think for that amount of money, you really are getting a great, great value. I actually think that these Weknives are probably the best value in the high-end production folding knife market. You get so much custom features with the proprietary titanium hardware, which is anodized. You also get the disassembly tool without extra charge with the knife. You have gorgeous, unique designs. You have a perfect flipping action with multi-row ceramic ball bearing system and detent. You get a very, very good steel with the S35VN. You also have a sharpening job that searches its competitor, and just the design work and the CNC machining that they put into their knives is just executed perfectly on each of these knives. And on this knife in particular, I think the Poco clip that they have come up with just shows you the capabilities that Weknife has to innovate and produce and CNC machine these unique high quality knives, and I would highly recommend to check them out. One other thing that I really like about this company is that they work with their customer base on Instagram, where they constantly introduce new prototype knife designs and ask for improvements and input from their customer base. So I would highly recommend to follow them on Instagram. I will leave a link in the description box as well. I'm absolutely blown away by both models I had from them. There is not a single flaw I could find on these knives, and I would certainly recommend them to anybody who is searching a high-end folder. So this was my review. I hope you liked it. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, please write it in the comment section below. I will try to answer you there as soon as possible. And if you want to see more of these knife, gun, and gear reviews, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.